Hi guys, Robbo46 and welcome to my race analysis and results for MotoGP Motegi 2014 after a hectic race at Aragon. It was more of a kind of, it's kind of like a more relaxed and subdued race compared to Aragon anyway. But drama pretty much started in qualifying when Andrea Dovizioso on the factory Ducati put it on pole for the first time since Casey Stoner. So that's a good few years since Ducati have had a pole position. So it's good to see him on pole position. Valentino Rossi got second in qualifying, so good front row for him. So come the race, off the line, Valentino Rossi got a fantastic start and got the whole shot straight away, followed by Dovizioso and Jorge Lorenzo. Both Marc Marquez and Dani Pedrosa both got shocking starts, and they're about 7th, 8th going into the first corner. Got a bit beaten up, but started to make their way forward pretty quickly. Andrea Iannone was 4th at the time, just behind Lorenzo. But yeah, a few laps in, Lorenzo got past Dovizioso and was hunting down Valentino Rossi. Unfortunately, Cal Crutchlow lost the front of his Ducati and crashed out. I think he just wants the season to be over now and get on that Honda. A bit disappointing for him, considering he got on the podium last race. I know it was a bit hectic, but the podium's a podium. But yeah, so Marquez started to make his way through the pack as well, first dispatching Andrea Iannone and then dispatching Andrea Dovizioso. Lorenzo got past Rossi and started to eke out a bit of a lead. And then a few more laps and Marquez was slowly catching Rossi. Pedrosa was starting to make a bit of progress, but it took him quite a while to get going this weekend for some reason. But he's starting to make his way forward. Marquez eventually got up to Rossi and they had a little battle which went a little bit like this. Basically, Marquez dived to the inside of Rossi, but Rossi had none of it and stuck around the outside up on the curb. Tried outbrake Marquez, but as we know, Marquez is good on the brakes, but maybe a little too good in this instance. He did run a little bit wide, which did let Rossi free, put Marquez up a little bit, and down the straight they went. Thought Marquez was going to have a go at the bottom of the hill, but he didn't have a chance. But following lap, pretty much exactly the same. Marquez got better drive out the corner than Rossi's, took it to the inside, put it up the inside of him. Rossi again tried to hang around the outside of Marquez, almost going on the grass. Tried to outbrake him again, didn't work again. Marquez went a little bit wide, but not very much. It did lure Rossi into a false sense of security and did compromise his exit speed, but that's how Marquez got past Rossi and he started to make his way forward and he gapped Rossi by about half a second. And then all of a sudden Pedrosa started closing in. So he closed the gap down to Rossi. It wasn't coming down massively, it was just like a few tenths here and there. But that was pretty much the race, to be honest. Bradley Smith and Paul Espargaro were having a battle a bit further down. We had a couple of four non-finishers. Caro Abraham crashed out. Johnny Hernandez crashed on the last lap. He was inside the top 10, battling with Alvaro Bautista, but eventually crashing on the last lap. Daniele Petrucci also had a retirement, as well as Crutchlow. But with one lap to go, Pedrosa, he was getting a bit closer to Rossi, and Rossi was kind of closing in on Marquez, and it was kind of yo-yoing. The last few laps, Rossi was closing down maybe 2/10 a lap, and then the next lap, Marquez would add another 2/10 onto his advantage, which just ended up averaging out as nothing. So Marquez's gap to Rossi was consistent, and Marquez had to beat Rossi and Pedrosa to take the title. which he did. Lorenzo went on to take a win. Great for Lorenzo. Should really boost his confidence now. I know he had a win in Aragon under strange conditions and a very hectic race, but good to get a dry win under his belt this year. Hopefully he can work and carry that momentum through to the end of the season and then start next season how he should have done this season. I know that he hasn't had the best of confidence this season, but it's great to see him back on full fight and form. So let's hope that Lorenzo can continue it. Marquez came home in second, which did give him the MotoGP World Championship of 2014. So he did defend his title. He defended it well, to be honest. Can't take anything away from him. 10 wins in a row. A couple of mistakes at a couple of races, but all in all, you know, I don't think he could have asked for any more this season. He set out what he wanted to do, maintain the title, and he'd done that and made it look pretty easy. Next season, I'm hoping it's going to be different. I know that the Yamahas are getting closer to the Honda now, but I also know that the Hondas next year, they've concentrated more on corner speed, which I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, because, I mean, obviously Yamaha's key strong points are being a real stable bike, good corner speed, and Honda's kind of pick it up and squirt out of the corners. But if Honda have got more corner speed, then yeah, it'll be a bit like the Yamaha and faster through the corners, but Marquez's riding style doesn't really use corner speed. Like I said, he does pick it up and fire out of corners, as well as Pedrosa, he does as well. So I don't know, it could be Honda's downfall. I'm sure it won't be. I'm sure Marquez will just adapt his riding style, but we'll have to wait and see. And Rossi came in with third, another podium for Rossi after that horrible crash in Aragon where he actually ended up breaking his index finger. He did say before the weekend that he's going to have to learn how to do one finger breaking, like Casey Stoner used to do. But I think during the race I saw him using three fingers, so I guess it didn't really affect him that much. But yeah, he got third. Danny Pedrosa came home in fourth. Andrea Dovizioso topped Ducati in fifth. Not bad after pole position. I'm sure he would have, loved to get on the podium. Andrea Iannone in sixth. Stefan Bradl, bit of a disappointing weekend for him at Honda's home circuit, seventh. Paulo Spraga was 8th, just ahead of Bradley Smith. Alvaro Bautista having a race-long battle with Hernandez ended up 10th. Alicia Spagro, disappointing for him really. I know he got to go in Parc Fermé as the top open bike, but 11th for him. He would have been disappointed with that. I mean, he looked disappointed in Parc Fermé. 12th was Katsuyuki Nakasuga, Yamaha's test rider, who's testing some new parts for the factory bikes for next year. You may remember him getting his podium in Valencia. Can't remember his last year or the year before. But yeah, good to see him back. Hiroshi Ayama at his home race got 13th, which was the top open Honda, so good for him. Just ahead of his teammate Nicky Hayden, 14th, Hector Barber on the Ducati, 15th. I think he had a transponder problem, Hector Barber, because throughout the whole race, the tower of names on the left-hand side of the screen, his just kept going straight to the bottom and then just reappearing, and then, yeah, just kept doing that, and so he's obviously glitching. Scott Redding just missed out on the points, bit of a disappointing weekend for him, in 16th. Alex De Angelis was 17th, Michael Laverty 18th, Mike Domeglio 19th, and Brock Parks was the last finisher in 20th. So that's all the results, guys. So Marquez is the crowning champion this year. I think he can relax now for the rest of the season. I know he was a bit tense going into Motegi, obviously being at Honda's home track, and the boss of HRC there, and basically expecting him to win. Well, not so much the race, but expecting him to win the title there. I know Rossi would have loved to have beaten Marquez so that he didn't win the title at Honda's home circuit. As we all know, Rossi hates Honda. But yeah, so I'm expecting to see a different Marquez for the last three races. Phillip Island next, so you can expect Marquez to come out all guns blazing, as he has nothing to lose anymore. He's got the title put away to bed, and he can just come out and have a bit of fun. I'm sure the other riders, Pedrosa, Lorenzo and Rossi and everyone else will just be trying to do the best they can to finish the season on a high. Before we go testing at the end of the season in Valencia, after the Valencia race, I'm looking forward to that test because, I mean, I'm looking forward to seeing Scott Redding on the factory Honda with Mark VDS. Also, Cal Crutchlow on the LCR Honda. And of course I want to see how the Suzukis go as well. I want to find out how close they are to the factory bikes, whether they're going to enter as open factory or open class or full factory or whatever. I mean, I think the sensible thing would be to do what Ducati have done, just because they're not going to know where they are in relation to the other bikes. They'll find that out when Randy Depunier wildcards in Valencia. So yeah, it'd be interesting to see, and obviously Jack Miller as well on the open Honda. Find out how he gets on as well. But yeah, so we've got a lot to look forward to. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to rev the nuts off that like button. Subscribe to my channel for more content, and I shall see you guys in the next video. See you.